This is JP from Nautilus over Arkham. This time I will be trying out Trish Scarbrough, and I will be trying out the new Cryptic Grimoire card that was introduced in the Innsmouth Conspiracy Deluxe Box, and it's the Seeker asset that we are used to seeing that needs translating. So this time the mechanic is a bit harder, at least in my opinion, so I thought that I will make a specific deck that tries to pull out the mechanic. Let's see the Trish deck first and see what I'm talking about. So we have Trish Scarbrough. Trish is a rogue investigator with access to 0 to level 2 seeker cards. Let's first look at the Cryptic Grimoire. It's a 3-cost asset. As an action, you can add 1 curse token to the chaos bag. And if there are 10 curse tokens in the chaos bag, you can, as an action, discard Cryptic Grimoire and record in your campaign log that you have translated the Grimoire and replace 5 curse tokens in the bag to 5 blessed tokens. So we are basically trying to translate the Grimoire. How am I doing that? Well, we have deep knowledge events in the deck that will add 2 curse tokens into the chaos bag and draw us more cards. We also have the rogue event Faustian Bargain that will add 2 curse tokens to the chaos bag and give us a lot of resources. We also have the Tempt Fate events, which add 3 chaos tokens to the chaos bag. I mean 3 curse tokens and 3 blessed tokens to the chaos bag. So with the combined effort with those cards, we can get to 10 curse tokens. In the Grimoire itself has an ability to add curse tokens. If we run short for some reason, we can use that to get to 10 curse tokens. And the way I'm thinking is because we usually are drawing from the chaos bag all the time, the curse tokens should be added in a short time period. So the preferred method is to add all of them during one turn. That is why I built the deck so it has a lot of card draw, so we can draw our events that combo adding the curse tokens. So we have Preposterous Sketches, also the Deep Knowledge doubles up as a card drawing card. We have Laboratory Assistance to get card draw into the deck and also give us bigger hand size. We of course need the Cryptic Grimoire, so we have a Research Librarian to fetch that for us. And then after we complete the translation, we have still 5 curse tokens in the bag, so we have Dark Rituals to get those out of the bag, so we can actually complete the scenario with a win condition. We are also getting a lot of resources in this build, so I added the Well-Connected into the deck. And of course we want to complete the scenario, so as Trish is good at investigating, we are focusing on enemy evasion and investigation, so we don't have a lot of ways to defeat enemies in this build. So of course I added as a safety card the 25 automatics, but we are mainly evading and investigating with Trish. I think that's enough of the deck. I haven't drawn my basic weakness yet, so I'll do that now. So I have all of the basic weaknesses in this card deck, so we shuffle it up and see which basic weakness Trish has. So we get the 13th vision. Okay, well, that's not that bad of a basic weakness. So we shuffle that into the deck. So let's see what scenario we are playing today. So I am playing this as a standalone. We are playing the Witching Hour from the Circle Undone expansion. Usually when I play this standalone, I will pick the Elder Thing tokens into the back because I don't want to add the tarot cards in the player deck. So we have two Elder Thing tokens and no tablet tokens in the back. We haven't picked the location we are starting in, but we'll do that when we start our first turn. Let's see if we can translate the grimoire, so let's get started. There is still one thing I forgot to mention, because the new taboo list came out yesterday. I haven't been able to play with the deck I was intending to. I actually had Mr. Rook in the deck, but because Mr. Rook got nerfed and has costs now 4 experience, I won't be using Mr. Rook, so that is why I have some changes in the deck that are the laboratory assistants and also the preposter sketches, but let's see. So we get the Cryptic Grimoire right from the get-go. We don't need the Dark Ritual from the start. I think we'll keep the Deep Knowledge. We could keep the preposterous sketches to draw more cards, but I'll redraw. Well, actually, let's redraw 3. Okay, well, we get both of the weapons, which isn't that helpful. And we get an eavesdrop. So we have to just get cards and evade enemies or investigate without any help. So yeah, let's see where we start. So actually these are random, but I'll just shuffle them up again. It really doesn't matter. So these all are connected, and I think I'll just start from this end. So we start at the Cairnstones location. It has a Shroud of 3 and 2 clues. Forced after any number of clues are discovered from this location, each investigator at this location loses an equal number of resources. So we really don't want to have a lot of resources at hand when we investigate here, so I think I will be starting my turn playing the 25 automatic, just in case, so we lose some resources. And then we can start investigating here. Just put the ammo onto the weapon. And then we'll just investigate. I'm investigating 4 versus 3. It's a minus 1, so we get the clue, and we also lose a resource. And we'll try to investigate the second time. And it's a minus 1 again, so we get this clue, but we don't have any resources. So that is the first turn. We ready up, we draw a card. We get Triss's signature event, which is the In the Shadows. This is really helpful if we happen to run into Triss's signature weakness enemy. And we also gain one resource. So that was the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. we add a Doom to the agenda, the threshold is 8. The first encounter card is dissonant voices. So we can't play assets or events this turn. That is okay. I'll just move to the next location as a first action. We get the Witch Haunted Woods Child's Treehouse. When the last clue is discovered from this location, spawn the topmost enemy in the encounter discard pile at this location. If there are no enemies in the encounter discard pile, discard cards from the top of the encounter deck until an enemy is discarded and spawn that enemy instead. So, okay. So two clues here. I think I'll just investigate twice. Or actually, I think I'll investigate once. I draw a card and I'll investigate next turn when I have actions to deal with the enemy that will spawn. So investigating, it's a minus one. So we get one clue and we'll draw a card for our last action. And we get the preposterous sketches, which I think I will play next turn, maybe. So, this goes away at the end of the round. We ready up, we draw a card, we get a ritual at the dark ritual, and we gain one resource. So, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a threat to the... we add a Doom to the agenda. The encounter card is Centuries of Secrets. Test will power 5. For each point you fail by, discard the top card of the encounter deck. If a cursed treasure is discarded by this effect, deal 1 direct damage to your investigator and to each of your ally assets. Well, let's see if I can boost this in any way. Well, I could... use the deep knowledge, but as that is one of my combo pieces, I won't do that, and I also could use proposed sketches, but I think I'll just test these 2 versus 5. So it's a minus 3, so we failed by 5. Let's discard cards. So it's a hex, it's an omen, it's a terror, it's a witch, and we hit a curse, so we'll take 1 damage, and it's direct. Okay, we go to the investigation phase. First action, I will investigate. This will trigger the witch we just discarded. We are investigating 4 versus 1. It's a 0. So we get this clue. And spawn the topmost enemy in the encounter discard pile. And it is the Coven Initiate. And we will evade it. I will use the other 25 automatic to boost this evasion. I'm evading 5 versus 2. It's a minus 1. So, this witch is evaded, and last action we'll use the 25 automatic to shoot the witch. Now, as the enemy is exhausted, we get plus 2 and deal plus 1 damage, so we are shooting 4 versus 2. And it's a plus 1. So this witch gets defeated. And that is our turn. So we draw a card, ready up and gain one resource. So we get the laboratory assistant, which is good because now we can get some soak and get more cards into our hand to get our combo pieces. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, the encounter card is. It's another Coven Initiate, so let's back up, because when we we didn't reveal this, so that did trigger, but now we reveal, discard the top two cards of the encounter deck if this effect causes the encounter deck to run out, etc. So we discard two cards, so we discard Diabolic Voices and Rotting Remains. Okay. And we don't discard the Witch. So that comes into play. So, I think we'll take one attack of opportunity and move here. So we take one horror. So we get Witch Hunted Woods Hermit's House. Forced after any number of clues are discovered from this location, each investigator at this location must discard an equal number of cards at random from his or her hand. And, well, that kind of sucks. I think we will ignore this location. We don't want to lose any of our combo pieces. So we'll just evade the Witch. So we'll evade. Should I commit anything? I think I will commit the eavesdrop. So I'm evading 5 versus 2. It's a minus 1, so this witch is evaded. And I think we can just leave the witch here, so I'll move to the next location. So it's the Witch Haunted Woods Overgrown Barn. It's a 3-shroud location with one clue. When an enemy would spawn at different Witch Haunted Woods, spawn it at this location instead, then it makes an immediate attack against each investigator at this location. Okay, so there's one clue here, and we go to upkeep. This guy readies, we draw a card, we get the lockpicks, and we gain one resource. So that is the turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom. We are at 4 of 8. The encounter card for this turn is Frozen in Fear. Well, that is actually quite annoying. So I think we try to get rid of that somehow at the end of the round. But so move, hide, evade are now costing, the first one is costing 2 actions. I'll just keep it here so I remember it better. Okay, I think the first action this round is to play the laboratory assistant. So when after laboratory assistant enters play, draw 2 cards. The maximum hand size is increased by 2, so we have a hand size of 10. We draw the 2 cards. We get obfuscation and higher education, none of which help us complete our main objective, and I'll play the, as a second action, the preposterous sketches. So we'll draw 3 cards as we have a clue at our location. So again, we don't hit any cards we really need. So we have 10 cards in hand. Just reorganizing a bit. So last action we'll investigate. I'll investigate 4 versus 1. It's a elder thing. It's a -3. If you fail, choose an exhausted or damage which enemy at your location or a connecting location, ready that enemy and heal all damage from it. Well, that and which doesn't have any damage on her, so at the end of our round we'll test the frozen fear. I'll commit the other cryptic grimoire to the test. I think I will commit higher education. And we are testing 4 versus 3. I think I'll have to risk it, and well, I think okay, we'll just try with those. So 4 versus 3. Okay, we get the auto fail, so lucky we didn't overcommit. We'll go to upkeep, we ready up, draw one card, we get the temp fate, and we gain one resource. Okay, so we still only have cards to add 5 tokens. 5 curse tokens, so we still need quite more to our combo. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add our doom, then counter card is evil past. Put evil past into play in your threat area if there is no copy of it in your threat area. Forced when the encounter deck runs out. Take 2 horror and test willpower 3. If you succeed, discard evil past. Well, let's continue. So I'll actually draw a card. We get the other attempt fate, which is really good for a combo. Now we have 6, 8. We actually might hit our objective with deep knowledge. So I think I will advance at this point. We'll investigate here. So we still need to actually play the grimoire. So I'll investigate, I'll commit the lockpicks, or should I? Yeah, I'll commit the lockpicks, I don't have time to play them. We are not hitting our resource cards for some reason. So I'm investigating 5 versus 3. It's an auto fail. Let's just investigate 4 versus 3 for fast. Action. And we fail. It's an elder thing. Okay, so we are just not getting this clue, apparently. We have 9 cards in hand. Enemy phase, nothing happens. Upkeep. Oh yeah, let's try to get rid of the frozen fear. I think I'll have to commit in the shadows for this chest, just to try to get... No, not that important. Okay, we just test 2 versus 3. So if we hit a +1 or elder sign, we succeed. So -2, we fail. We draw a card, we get the well connected, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn, let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. We are at 6 of 8 doom. Encounter card is bedeviled. put bedeviled into play in your threat area. You cannot trigger action abilities on cards you control, which is really crippling. And test willpower 3 if you succeed, discard bedeviled. Okay. Well, let's just set up this turn. I'll get one resource. I'll play the Cryptic Grimoire down. Last action, let's investigate. I'm committing the well connected. I don't see myself playing that. I don't have the resources to pump that at the moment. So testing 5 versus 3. It's a skull. Skull is minus 1. For each point you fail by, discard the card of the counter deck. But we succeed, so we get this clue. We have 8 cards in hand. Enemy phase, nothing happens. We test Frozen Fear. Do I really try to get rid of that somehow? No, we'll just try to hit the plus one our elder sign. It's a minus 3, so we fail and we draw a card. We get another well connected, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 7, Doom of 8. The encounter card is Rotting Remains. Okay. This I think we will just take into the face. So testing 2 versus 3. We get a minus 2, so we take 3 horror. I'll take 2 on myself, 1 on the laboratory assistant. And that is that. Now I think we will use 2 clues and advance. Oh yeah, this is only at the end of the round. So I think I'm just trying to get the rest of the combo pieces. So let's draw a card. We get Cryptic Grimoire, not helpful. Let's draw a card. We hit the Shadow Agents. Well, this is actually not good. Because we don't have the actions to evade anymore. Well, that sucks. We could play the into the shadows, but I think I'll save that for next turn. I don't have the resources to play obfuscation. And that Frozen in Fear is really troublesome. Well, what can you do? Last action, I just won't do anything for my last action. Okay, so enemy phase, this enemy hits us for 2 damage. And we'll test the Frozen Fear actually. Okay, so 2 versus 3. And actually we get a plus 1, so this is discarded. That really will help us. We draw a card, we gain one resource, and we have 11 cards in hand. I think I'll discard one of the obfuscations. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. The agenda advances. So, the right commences, discard all but the 5 cards from the last 5 cards of the encounter deck. The investigator with the most cards in his or her play area must draw the topmost which enemy at the enemy in the encounter discard pile. Okay. So there's only 5 cards in the discard pile, so we discard cards. Okay, well, luckily we get the Coven Initiate, which will discard 2 more cards. But still, we didn't get the other, the harder witch. And now we actually, if we evade this, we can get rid of the deviled. So, encounter card for this turn is Ancient Evils. So we get one doom here. So forced at the end of the round, place one doom on this agenda for each witch enemy at witch's circle. Well, the witch's circle is not in play yet, so we don't have to care about that. Oh yeah, this is engaged. Let's put the token on the shadow agents also. So this turn I think I'm just evading. And again, yeah, I forgot to advance, so I think I'll try to resolve these enemies, get rid of them before advancing. Okay, first action, evading the shadow agents. I'm evading, I'll commit the in the shadows to this test, and I will also commit Nimble to the test, because I want to move out with this Coven Initiate from the here. So, evading 9 versus 5, and it's a minus 1. So, the Shadow Agents gets discarded when it's evaded, so we get rid of that weakness, luckily. And also, we succeeded by a taunt. We'll just move here. Actually, that doesn't matter at all, but well, we need to get rid of some cards in hand. Second action, we'll evade this witch. I'm evading 4 versus 2. And it's a skull, it's a minus 1. So this is evaded. And last action, I'll get rid of this bedevil. This which readies, it's engaged with us again. We draw a card, we get eavesdrop. 9 cards in hand, we gain 1 resource, and that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, encounter card is another bedeviled, so this turn will be a repeat from the last turn. So first action, we'll evade. I'll commit the eavesdrop to the test. No, I'll actually save that for the last occasion. No, let's commit it. 5 versus 2. It's a minus 2, so we evade. Second action, let's get rid of bedeviled. Last action, we'll move over here, so that witch won't engage us again. So I'll just move it over here. Then enemy phase, nothing happens, upkeep, we ready up. We draw a card, we get the other side, cryptographic cipher. We have 9 cards, and we gain 1 resource. Now we will advance the act. So each investigator must randomly choose one of the set-asized Arkham Woods. So we have the Arkham Woods locations here. We shuffle them up. that. I'll just move this up. So we move to that, we reveal it. And it's luckily the Arkham Woods cliffside. It's a two-shot location with one clue. This location is investigated using agility instead of the skill indicated by the investigate attempt. So that is actually really lucky for us. Its investigator spawns the set aside code spawn enemy. At his or her location. Each investigator then tests the willpower or agility tree. Each investigator who succeeds exhausts that enemy and disengages from it. Shuffle the set aside copies of demonic piping into the encounter deck. So one copy goes into the encounter deck. And the rest goes into the encounter discard. So let's shuffle this. So with a pretty big guarantee we'll getting that next gen. Okay, let's test the agility. I'm not committing anything, so 4 versus 3. Really hoping to hit this. Well, we don't, so it comes into play engaged with us. Okay, so then I think we'll do that next turn. So that is our turn. We have 9 cards in hand. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. The encounter card is... it's wrecked. Okay, so we put wrecked in play. The first skill test is -1 for each round. So I think I will, as a fast action, play obfuscation. Comes into play with 3 charges. We'll investigate here. I'll use agility and I'm using 1 charge from the obfuscation, so we cancel the attack of opportunity. Investigating 4 versus 2, and we get an elder sign. Let's check what that does, because I honestly can't remember. If this is an investigation, you may choose any revealed location you are now investigating as if you were at that location instead. I think I'll just grab this one. But this god spawn is evaded. So after you discover 1 or more clues at your location with the enemy, either discover 1 additional clue at that location or automatically evade that enemy. Okay, so actually we were investigating 3 versus 2, but that's neither here nor there. We succeeded. We still have to try and get... okay, well, I think I'm advancing this now. So, strange melodies for the remainder of the scenario. Investigators may now enter location in front of other investigators. Then we still have 3 clues, so I'll advance this. Actually, let's not do that next turn. So we still have 2 actions. I'll move back here. and so I'll play the other laboratory assistant to draw two cards. Okay. And this is discarded. So, because these are not unique, I can just change them, basically. So now we have the combo pieces to get the Cryptic Grimoire, and I'm doing that next turn. So, last action, I will. I will gain a resource. Yeah. Okay, let's see. So we have 3, 6, 8, 10. So we have enough to trigger the Cryptic Grimoire next turn. Let's just hope we don't hit anything that costs us an action next turn. Okay, enemy phase, nothing happens, upkeep, everything readies. We draw a card and gain our resource, we get Lone Wolf, well, that's quite late. But yeah, that is that turn, let's go to the next turn. Okay, and we add a Doom to the agenda. Last encounter card is Demonic Piping. We actually take 2 horror because these triggers will test the willpower. Do we have anything to boost? We have the preposterous sketches, let's just omit that. And it's a +1. We actually get rid of this. Okay. And it searches. Well, it's -1. Yeah, we fail. I forgot that Bract is in play, so yeah, we didn't get rid of the evil past, but I think that doesn't matter anymore. We shuffle the encounter deck and Demonic Piping searches. So yeah, we don't shuffle that. Put it into play. Okay, and the next counter card is. Damn it. Dissonant Voices, so. We can't play events or. We can't play events or. Assets. Okay, well. That sucks. So, well, it is what it is. I'll just advance the act. So we get the Witch's Circle. Put the Witch's Circle into play in the center of the play area, in front of none of the investigators. So I'll just put it here. So it's actually. Let's shuffle this a bit so we can get it all nicely into frame. Okay. So it has 3 clues on it. After the enemy phase begins, move each ready and engage which enemy wants towards the Witch's Circle. Okay. And we spawn an animation here. Ah! There she is. Shuffle this. Okay, let's move here. first action. Second action, I will investigate. I will cancel the attack opportunity. I will commit a cryptographic cipher and will connect it to the test. Investigating 5, 6 versus 3. So it's a -3, so we succeed. So we actually grab 2 clues from here. Because I have the choice. So one additional clue or evade an enemy. And then I think we try to... Actually, I'll do it the other way around. I'll just grab the one clue. Oh. And yeah, I'll evade Annette. And last action, we'll investigate again. I'll use the dark ritual and cipher. It's a -1, we get the clue, but we can only trigger Chris's ability once. Okay. That goes away. So... So we move each... Okay, so I think we have the combo pieces, but I'm not gonna be able to complete the Grimoire if I intend to win this scenario. So both of these move once towards the Witcher Circle, and they engage. Oh yeah, and we'll have to. Yeah, we have to discard. So we don't hit Witch, so Annette is readied, and Annette will hit us for 1 and 1. Yeah. And... Oh yeah. Let's... just back up so that I took 2 clues, and I'll just win the scenario by taking the 3rd clue, because I totally forgot these witches move in. So yeah, a bit of backtracking, but we'll at least manage to win the scenario. But unfortunately, we weren't able to complete the Cryptic Grimoire. If we wouldn't have hit that dissonant voices, I would have played the Grimoire this turn and ignore everything else. Next turn I would have just moved in and won the scenario, but it is what it is. Sometimes you get screwed by the encounter deck. So to recap, I would have played this as a fast action. It would have added 3 curse and 3 bless tokens into the back. Then I would have drawn a card. Then I played a second one. The same thing happens. And draw a card. Yeah, okay, well, then we had the Faustian Bargain. 2 more curse tokens and 5 resources. Just take that. And I think I would have played the other Faustian Bargain in this situation. So that is 2 actions. Then last action, we would have triggered the Grimoire. So 5 of these tokens would have been converted into Bless tokens. So we would have had those tokens in the bag at the end of that round. Next round I would have started advancing and moved in, investigated, grabbed two clues, ignored the attack opportunity and investigated again, and again I would have spent the last charge and win the campaign, the scenario. But yeah, I think it is doable, but we just got screwed by this dissonant voices, which is a real shame, because I really wanted to demonstrate that it is doable. But yeah, hope you guys like this deck testing video. I'm intending to try out some weird combos in the future. If you have a interesting combo in mind around some specific card, let me know in the comments, and thanks for watching, and until next time.